This is Jeff Scott Soto from the band Soto. We got BJ over here at the end, plays keys and guitar, from Sao Paulo, Brazil as well. We have Edu Caminato on drums and vocals, Tony Dickinson bass and vocals, and Jorge Salon over here on lead guitar and vocals. Soto started back in 2015. I was transitioning from my solo career. I was working on a record that was a little too heavy. It wasn't as Jeff Scott Soto's solo album oriented sounding as the others turned out. So the manager at the time I was working with decided we need to put a band name. We need to put a brand behind this because it doesn't sound like a Jeff Scott Soto solo record. And that's initially how Soto got started. We kept it simple, just used my last name for the identity side of things. And voila, you know, we had a heavier, progressive, modern sounding band. Today we have two albums released. The first one, So today we have two records released. The first one was Inside the Vertigo back in 2015. And in 2016, we got our second album immediately released. It was an album called Divac. And now we have album number three. We just finished and it's coming out this year, 2019, and it's called Origami. In 2017, shortly after the tour for Divac, we just wrapped up the European tour. Unfortunately, we lost our bass player, David Z. And it really took us a bit to kind of step back and realize what we were gonna do, when we were gonna do it. We were all busy in our own right after the Soto tour, so we had a little time to buy. Tony here has been involved with the band since the very beginning. Tony contributed a song to the first album as well as the second song. Both were actual singles. So in the back of my head, when we lost David, I didn't want to rush to any conclusions or any thoughts of replacing David. But in moving forward, it was always in the back of my mind that not only do I need to bring up with the guys that Tony's the obvious choice to step in, but I had to make sure Tony wanted to actually step in just the same. So we were very fortunate in every sense of the word, because not only was he was already instrumental in our earlier records and a part of the band, so to speak, on the outside, but he was very much interested in coming in and stepping in and helping us move into the future.
There are actually two songs on Origami that still have Dave Z's original bass parts. At the end of 2016, we did a cover of Michael Jackson's Give In To Me and self-released it and just kind of threw it out there to see if people would be into it. And we also did a song called Detonate that David and Edu wrote in the back of the bus on the last Soto tour. We just took Dave's original bass track that he laid right there at the back of the bus and we rebuilt the entire song around him because we wanted to immortalize him and use a song that he co-wrote with us for Origami and just kind of show that he's still part of this band and will always be part of this band.
In late 2016, I was approached by Mike Portnoy to join forces with him and Derek Sherinian and Billy Sheehan for a new project, something that they were working on. We didn't know exactly what it was going to be, what it was all about, but I jumped in head first because I've always wanted to work with Mike and Billy in the same project together. And then eventually we got Bumblefoot. From that, we have the band Sons of Apollo. And all of 2018 was spent on the road promoting that debut album. But from that, I was able to bring Soto into the same umbrella. And we're now working with Inside Out Music, which we're very excited about. I think we are in very good hands, and I'm very much looking forward to what they can do for us and what we can do for them. So the name of the album is called Origami, and it was, I love the name, I love the actual word origami. It was actually presented to us from our manager, Chris. There was a song that Tony came to the table with. It was really heavy, really progressive. And as I was writing the lyrics, there was nothing in the actual song lyrically that I wanted to actually title the song. So I sent the lyrics to all the guys, and say, hey guys, just look through this. If you see anything in here that strikes a nerve, let me know, because I have no idea what to call this song, this actual song. And it was Chris that saw it, and he kind of pieced together the idea of what Origami means and presented it to us. I thought the title was so strong as a song, I thought it would actually be even stronger as an album title, because this band does represent an international flair. You got two guys from Brazil, you got one from Spain, and Tony and I are the mutts from the US. But we basically have three continents intertwined in one band here. The second album was called Divac, it was a Bulgarian word, and now we have Origami, which is a Japanese word. It just keeps that whole international flair going on with what we're doing or trying to do. This is not Jeff Scott solo, this is Soto the band, and we are democratic and diplomatic in every sense of the word. When it comes to the songwriting, I push these guys to give their best and do as much as they possibly can to contribute to the sound of the band, to contribute to everything that we're doing, into everything from the albums to the live shows. And so the songs are basically written and contributed by the guys in the band for the most part. And we have a couple outside writers, people that I've been working with for a while, as well as these guys from Brazil. But Tony really stepped up, as he did one song on each of the first two albums. On this one, he's got quite a few, as well as co-produced with myself and Adu on this one.
I'm really honored that these guys let me step in and take a large role in producing the album. When Jeff was like, let's put a brass section on this song, and I was like, I'm going to do it because I love that. Love writing brass parts. I love writing orchestra. And I'm really happy that these guys trust that what I'm going to do for the song will sound good and let me do it. And they seem to like what I'm doing, and I love producing music. So I'm really happy to be able to take a large part in kind of defining the sound of Soto.
And this guy wears glasses at night.